So in this video, I'm going to talk about 1PropZInterval. And this function is used when you're doing a one proportion confidence interval. Where we find it is by going to stat and scrolling over to tests. And there's a lot of tests here, so you gotta really pay attention. We do want 1PropZInterval. So I'm gonna scroll down. And for me, it's A, so 1PropZInterval, I'm going to press enter. Now it says, the example I have, we have a survey that was given in 2018. They asked 160 American Democrats how they felt about Medicare for All, and 136 of them said they support it. So our job is to find a 95% confidence interval estimate for the true proportion of Democrats in America who support Medicare for All. So 1PropZInterval wants X, N, C level, and calculate. So you can probably guess that C level is confidence level. It defaults to 0.95, so I don't need to change that, but I would. Notice it is written as a decimal. Your X is essentially your number of successes, and that's just the number of people who said they agree with something or didn't agree with something or had something or didn't have something, but it's like, what is the question? And this question was if they supported something, and 136 of them said yes. N is your total number of people that were surveyed, so 160 in this case. You do want that X to be smaller than the N, so that's important as well. So X over N is your sample proportion, and then the calculator does a bunch of work using that confidence level. And when you press calculate, it's going to give you a few things. So it gives you the confidence interval. It gives you the 0.79467. That's the left-hand side or lower bound of the interval. And it gives you 0.90533. That is the upper bound or right side of the confidence interval. In the middle of that confidence interval is that p hat, which is the 0.85, which is your sample proportion from the problem that you were given. And N, of course, is a value that you gave the calculator, which is the total number of people surveyed. So make sure you know how to interpret a confidence interval if you need to, but that is how to use 1PropZInterval for a confidence interval using a one proportion situation.